hooks. Probably the first or second thing you think of when you think about overhead lifting. There are a lot of different hooks, but which is the right hook for your application? When should I use this hook versus this hook? In this video, I'm gonna break down the differences so you can better understand the features and benefits of the different hooks and decide which is the best hook for your application. First and foremost, if you're using a hook for overhead lifting, you must first make sure that the hook is designed for overhead lifting. It must also be designed for the application it will be used. Different lifting hooks have different requirements depending on their application. For example, the requirements for hooks on chain slings may differ from those of wire rope slings. There are hooks designed for the transport industry and other non-overhead lifting applications. They are not manufactured to the specifications required for overhead lifting. Do not use these hooks for overhead lifting applications. If a hook is not meant for overhead lifting, you will see in the product description, catalog, warning label, or use and care manual that it is not to be used for overhead lifting applications. Lifting with a hook not designed for overhead lifting can be extremely dangerous. All right, let's start with the top of your hook, your connecting point. How is your hook connecting to whatever it is connecting to, be that a sling, a crane block, overall ball, hoist, whatever. When you're looking at the connecting point, you have several different types of hooks. You have eye hooks, clevis hooks, shank hooks, swivel hooks, sliding hooks, synthetic hooks, and weld-on hooks. Let's start with the swivel hook, as there is a lot of confusion in the industry with these. There are two different types of swivel hooks, and it's important to know the difference. If you choose the wrong one for your application, it can lead to a load failure. The two hooks are positioning swivel hook and a swivel hook with ball bearings. From now on, just to alleviate the confusion, I'm going to refer to a positioning swivel hook as a positioning hook. A positioning hook, also called a bronze bushing hook, can swivel, but it is not meant to swivel under load. The hook can swivel to allow the rigger to properly position and align the hook when connecting and rigging the load. But if allowed to swivel while lifting the load, the shank will eventually shear, resulting in a catastrophic failure. Do not force swivel your positioning hook when under load. If you need your hook to swivel under load, you should use a swivel hook with ball bearings. This can be used when attaching tag lines or utilizing no-touch tools to rotate your load into a specific position. Both your swivel hook with ball bearings and your positioning hook can be used with chain, wire rope, synthetics, and more. A shank hook is your most basic. Its shank can often be threaded by the end user after purchase. The most common applications for a shank hook is to install the hook into a crane block. Sometimes it's swaged directly onto a wire rope. Eye and clevis hooks are probably the most common. This is an eye hook. The top of your hook features an eye, giving you a lot of flexibility in terms of movement and ergonomics when positioning the hook and attaching it to the load. You can find regular eye hooks like this and reverse eye hooks when the eye is turned to face the front. Eye hooks can be used with chain, wire rope, synthetics. They are extremely versatile in their many different uses in the lifting industry. The benefits of versatility and ergonomics do come with a drawback though. When it comes to sling assemblies, this hook is often a permanent fixture. If the hook is damaged, it is not easily replaced, and the entire sling would need to be pulled from service and replaced or sent for repairs. A clevis fastener is a fastener system consisting of a clevis and a pin. The clevis is a U-shaped piece with holes for a pin, which is used to fasten the hook to a bracket or a chain. Chain slings with mechanical connections use clevis hooks. The chain is not welded around the hook's connecting point. The advantage of this is that the hook can be removed and replaced should it be damaged. Also, if a rigging shop is not certified to weld alloy chain slings, they utilize a clevis hook on a mechanical chain sling. Although easy to repair, one thing to note is that if a company replaces the hook themselves, they assume responsibility and liability for the sling and must put their name on the sling tag. They must also have the sling proof tested after the repair. Repair must be done with the correct parts designated by the manufacturer and not homemade solutions. A cotter pin style clevis hook is not to be used for overhead lifting. The disadvantage of a clevis hook is that components can wear out quicker, and clevis hooks do not offer the same flexibility as an eye hook, although clevis swivel and positioning hooks are available from some manufacturers. Sliding choker hooks are built into a sling and made to slot. They are used to make choking processes safer and more efficient. Your D-to-D ratio is increased, which can help protect the sling from excessive distortion. Plus, efficiency and productivity are increased because you no longer need to take the sling off the crane hook to disconnect and reconnect the choke. A sliding hook is safer than using a shackle for the same operation, as a shackle runs the risk of being used improperly and unthreading the pin. You have versions of these for wire rope, chain, and synthetics. Synthetic hooks often can be considered flat eye hooks, although they do come in several different styles. The main purpose of these hooks is to protect your synthetic slings. They are designed with a wide beam surface to eliminate sling bunching and allow for better load distribution on synthetic slings. Weld-on hooks are just that, hooks that are welded to whatever they are connecting to. These hooks are often welded to mobile lifting equipment and excavators. All right, now that we've covered the different types of connecting points, hopefully you have a better idea of the hook type that you need to best connect to your sling, chain, rope, lifting device, or whatever you're connecting to. Let's dive into the actual hook part of your hook and the different options available. There are a ton of different types of hooks for overhead lifting. Some hooks are for cranes, some are for slings, some have specialty functions, many are very common in some industries and rare in others. I'm going to cover as many of the different types of hooks as I can to help you decide which is the right hook for your application. Let's start with the most common. Hooks that have spring-loaded latches are known by many different names: self-closing hooks, snap hooks, sling hooks, rigging hooks. I'm sure you have heard of more. These are hooks that have a spring-loaded latch gate, or bail, that closes the throat opening of the hook. It needs to be manually opened for loading and closes upon release. The latch is intended to retain items like slings and rigging hardware under slack conditions, but it is never intended to support the load. There is always a bit of controversy in the industry on whether or not latches are required on hooks. A hook latch really depends on the application being performed. For example, if you work in a steel mill or a foundry, there could be an inherent danger in having a human connect and disconnect a load over high heat. In this case, it is safer to use a hook without a latch. We'll get into those specific hooks later. OSHA 1910 states, safety latch type hooks shall be used wherever possible. ASME B3010 hooks cites an inoperative latch as hook removal criteria. A good rule of thumb to follow is that if the hook is designed and intended to have a latch, then the latch should be installed on the hook and functioning properly. Should the latch be damaged or fall off in the field, but the hook itself is undamaged, you can buy a new latch kit, replace the latch, and continue using your hook. The advantages of self-closing hooks are that they are quick and easy to connect and disconnect. The disadvantage is that it's easy to damage the latch compared to positive latching hooks or self-locking hooks. This is a self-locking hook. They're also known as positive latching hooks, self-latching hooks, and often colloquially known as safety hooks. They have a throat opening that will close and lock when a load is applied and will not open until the lock is manually released. The advantages of self-locking hooks are first and foremost safety. A load will not slip off the hook when using a self-locking hook. The latch cannot be opened until the weight of the load is off the hook and manually released, preventing premature release of the load. The second big advantage is durability. With a forged latch built into the hook itself, you do not have to worry about the latch being easily damaged or the spring wearing out. The disadvantage would be that it may take a bit more time to attach and disconnect your load due to the manual release required, and the price is gonna be higher along with the weight. Both self-closing hooks and self-locking hooks are for the most part interchangeable in their applications. This is a Foundry hook. As you might have noticed, no latch. Foundry hooks are designed with a wide, deep throat to fit trunnions and handles on molds or castings for foundry work. Foundry hooks are typically used on chain slings or on the hoists of overhead cranes operating in high heat environments. As we noted earlier, if the use of a latch would endanger the rigger, such as rigging over extremely hot items in a foundry, then a latch is not required. ASME B30.2, Overhead and Gantry Cranes, states in the hook section, latch-equipped hooks shall be used unless the application makes the use of the latch impractical or unnecessary. In these cases, a foundry hook is often best for your application. Sorting hooks are also known by several different names, like layout hooks and shakeout hooks. They are used to lift things that require a long, narrow throat opening, such as flat plates, steel beams, pipes, or other tube-shaped objects. Sorting hooks also do not use a latch, as that would impede the practical use of the hook. To use the full working load limit of the hook, the load must be fully engaged with the entire throat opening. This requires the hook to be used at a 30 to 40 degree angle. If the hook is being loaded at a 45 degree angle or greater, or the load is not sitting in the bottom of the hook, there will be a significant reduction in the working load limit. You'll find these hooks largely used in ironwork, pipework, and the oil and gas industries. This is a J hook. This is an S hook. You can tell the difference because this one looks like a J, and this one looks like an S. J hooks and S hooks are used for special lifting applications. They're often used in industrial manufacturing. As they have slimmer profiles, they can be used in applications where a sling hook or a foundry hook would be too large to fit and make a positive connection to the load, or where a wide throat opening is desired. They are often custom engineered for specific applications and most commonly are used without latches. As they are made with less material than standard hooks, they usually have a lower working load limit than other hooks. The eyes on J-hooks can come in several different styles, including traditional and reverse, and include single or double hooks. Never make your own S or J-hook for overhead lifting. Even though they look less engineered than your traditional hooks, these are engineered and tested to maintain their design factor and working load limit. Grab hooks are used to grab and shorten lengths of chain in a chain sling assembly. They have a very narrow throat that engages the chain between the links for non-slip handling. They are designed to grab specific sizes and grades of chain. There are two types of grab hooks, and this is very important. You need to know which type of grab hook is on your sling, as it will affect the sling's working load limit. The cradle grab hook is now what is most common in the industry. It has a thicker cradle at the bottom of the hook to better support the chain link. This often means that there is no reduction in the working load limit when the chain sling is used in accordance with the manufacturer's recommendations. The standard grab hook is becoming less common in the lifting industry. It does not have a cradle. As it does not have a cradle to support the chain link, when shortening chain, there will be a reduction in the working load limit, usually by 20%, depending on the manufacturer. Double hooks, sometimes called sister hooks, ram's horns, twin, or duplex hooks. These heavy-duty hooks are used for lifting very heavy loads. They are used for steel fabrication, offshore and marine lifting, shipbuilding, container shipping ports, and more. The two-hook design helps distribute the load and prevent sling damage. You can also find quads that have four hooks. Ladle J hooks or ladle hooks are specially engineered and designed to lift and transport molten metal. These hooks are primarily used in the metals industry. They are made of laminated steel plates, usually riveted together, sometimes bolted. They are built to work in extremely hot environments while lifting anywhere from 10 to hundreds of tons. Drum and barrel hooks are used for lifting barrels or drums. They have a wide endpoint that goes under the lip of the barrel and are used in conjunction with a multi-leg sling assembly. They are designed to be utilized at 30 to 45 degree angles. Automatic hooks are becoming more common in the lifting industry. These hooks are designed to remove the rigor from the rigging process, ensuring a much safer lifting environment. They come in all shapes and sizes. Some are remote control operated. Others are spring-loaded, working from the forces applied by the load and the crane, while others require tag lines to release the load. Automatic hooks, such as the ones made by Alibia, are common in ports and the metals industry and are becoming more common in many other industries as today's focus on safety becomes vital. There are a ton of different hooks out there. Some have specialty functions, like container hooks, made for lifting containers, or plate hooks for lifting plates or flats. But this should cover most of your choices and what you will see in the field. If we miss the hook that you want covered, drop it in the comments. Hopefully now you have a better understanding of which hook might be best for your lifting application. When selecting a hook, several factors should be considered. Ask yourself, how much does my load weigh? What is the working load limit needed for my hook? How am I planning on connecting the hook? How am I planning to lift the load? What are the connection points on the load, or what is the hitch I plan to use? What other pieces of rigging might I need to lift this load, and will they fit on my hook? What types of slings will be used? What sling angle will be required? What type of environment will the hook be used in? If you need some help determining the best hook for your application, planning your lift, or determining the correct type of equipment, slings, or hardware, then we're here to help. At Mozilla, we understand that determining the best equipment for your application can be difficult. So, feel free to contact us so our experts can help you get what you need and everyone on your rigging and lifting team stay safe. Contact us through the link below. If you found this video useful, informative, entertaining, or you just feel like being friendly, then hit that like button so we can get this information out to everyone who needs it. Subscribe and hit the bell so you never miss a video. If you have a question, drop it in the comments so we can get you an answer. Remember, safe rigging is smart rigging. My name is Ben. Stay safe out there.